We have a Hunter's Fate Sniper in the back, a Firecrest support damage build on our right, and a Reclaimer in the middle. They're so squishy they would die in a single shot, and that's why we need someone on the front line, a get up in their face kind of guy, a real tank. And for us, the defense gear set is the solution to all our problems. Before starting, I designed blueprints of the gear, weapon, skills and talents with all the information you need and uploaded those on Patreon. It's for those who are interested in being able to have a look at the build without rewatching the video again. These are one among many rewards for patrons, so if you're willing to support Masterminds HD monetarily, you can find the specifics on Patreon. Where the build will revolve around the ballistic shield, it would be nothing without the corresponding gear set. D3 FNC, or the defense gear set, is what we'll equip from top to bottom, granting us access from the 2 to the 6 piece bonus. The 2 piece increases protection from elites by 15%, which makes us a little more resistant to those yellow bastards' damage. The 3 piece adds on top of that 10% ballistic damage resilience. The 4 piece adds the frontline talent. It allows the user to equip a submachine gun during the use of the ballistic shield, at the cost of any mods. Except for the master mod, of course, the health of the ballistic shield is increased by 57% for every 3000 stamina we acquire. But we have two more set bonuses to gain. The 5-piece bonus increases the protection from elites by another 15% and adds 5% ballistic shield damage resilience. Add the 6-piece talent to unlock the improved frontline talent, which has 4 effects. 1. It increases our melee damage by 2000%. 2. Any overhealing the user receives is applied to the ballistic shield. 3. Upon reaching 9000 stamina, the ballistic shield health is doubled, meaning 200% increase. And 4. The ballistic shield grants a buff to the user and all group members within 50 meters, depending on the type of damage that's applied. Physical damage, meaning bullets and explosions, increase our armor by 30%. Exotic damage increases our weapon damage by 30%. The duration of either of these buffs lasts 6 seconds at the baseline, but can be increased by 2 seconds for every 3000 stamina, meaning it can last up to 12 seconds if we reach that 9000 stamina. That was quite the list already, and those were only the bonuses. Every piece of gear also has main stats, armor, major and minor attributes, as well as slots for prototype and performance mods. When specking into the main stats, we'll focus on getting 9000 stamina. We don't want any more than that, because we'll spend those towards firearms to make sure we can unlock the weapon talents. And in turn it increases our damage output a little bit as well. Keep in mind that the holster rolls 1401 on every main stat, giving us that extra bit of every main stat. Armor rolls are different for each of the 6 gear pieces. On screen, the maximum values are showcased. If we optimize our build, this is one of those things we don't have to worry about. The major attributes are the next most important attribute on our gear besides the main stats. There's two ways to go with this, PvE or PvP. For those that are looking for a PvE build, selecting health, enemy armor damage and exotic damage resilience are key. This way we can put out some damage as well. Add to this the critical hit chance and critical hit damage to increase our effective damage, and we're all set. However, PvP is a little different. Health is still the smartest option, but other than that, skill power, exotic damage resilience and critical hit damage are what we will choose. The gloves are the only gear piece that can roll specific weapon damage, and here we'll be selecting submachine gun damage up to 12%, regardless of if we play PvE or PvP. Minor attributes are a little bit simpler, but still differ slightly. Using this build for PvE, we'll be selecting damage versus elites, but other than that, we'll have burn resistance, blind death resistance and ammo capacity. But if we intend to play PvP, replacing damage versus elites with ammo capacity or disorient resistance could optimize it just that little bit more. The gear mods we're selecting come in two types, prototype and performance mods. There are 5 prototype mods, 3 of which we're rolling with stamina to reach that 9000, and 2 of which we should roll with firearms as a main stat to up that just a little bit. Roll these up to 267 to optimize this, and the minor attributes on these mods are debatable, but once again choosing between PvE and PvP is the option. PvE means you can select critical hit chance for that extra bit of damage, 5 times 1% for a total of 5%. For PvP we want a little more tankiness, so to speak, so we'll select skill power. And that skill power rolls between 2837 and 3335. The performance mods increase the bonuses on the skills. Here again we can look for PvE or PvP mods. With PvE in the back of our minds we want to select the ballistic shield damage with 3-4% for a total up to 16%. However, we'll select 4 ballistic shield damage resilience mods, increasing our tankiness, each rolling with 4-5% for a total of up to 20% extra ballistic shield damage resilience for the PvP side of things. That is the gear part of our build, meaning we're moving on to the weapons. The primary weapon of choice is the house. It's the most effective submachine gun at the moment, mostly due to its exotic talent. Card counter, as it's called, increases the weapon damage by 20% for half of the magazine, and the half which deals increased damage flips after 15 seconds or when it's empty. The second talent we're looking for is deadly, to increase critical hit damage by 15%. Combined with the submachine gun's natural critical hit chance bonus, this works wonders. The third and final talent on this weapon is hurried, increasing our reload speed by 10% for each critical hit we manage to hit. This goes up to 1 second, but as we're built around critical hits, this is just perfect. The secondary weapon is up to us, but keep in mind that we want something for medium to longer ranges to have some viability at those ranges. I'm always choosing the lightweight M4 in the second slot, as it's simply the best assault rifle at medium to close ranges. It handles decently, has a high rate of fire, and it has good damage. Of course, you're free to select whatever you want here, but in terms of most effectiveness, you want to select the lightweight M4. Deadly and hurried are the same. Besides that, we'll run destructive. Destructive adds 10% armor damage, adding to the naturally high armor damage on assault rifles already. We're not focusing on headshots with this one, as we're focusing targets at longer range than usual, and our build is set up for body shots and critical hits. This can be seen in the choice of mods, which is the same for both weapons. The optic of choice is the Pro Red Dot Sight with its increased critical hit damage. The minor attributes on the mod should be critical hit chance and headshot damage. In the magazine slot, we'll equip the extended magazine, naturally. It increases the magazine size by an insane amount, and other than that, we're looking for critical hit chance and rate of fire. The underbarrel supports the small grip, which we'll use to increase the critical hit damage, accuracy and reload speed. The final mod, the muzzle, is the loud vent break. It increases critical hit damage, critical hit chance and headshot damage as well. The sidearm depends, as per usual, on more on personal preference rather than statistics. I like the Golden Rhino because of its exotic weapon talent, so I will run with that. The Golden Rhino talent increases the stagger by 200%, and with its high damage and this effect, I can crowd control rushes sometimes, which can be nice from time to time. The other weapon talent is Always Expert, increasing the damage by 100% when the target is lower than 30%, which is nice for finishing people off, which you're mostly going to be using this for, if you use it at all. Its mods are the Reflex Sight with critical hit chance, critical hit damage and stability, as well as the Small Laser Pointer with accuracy, critical hit damage and reload speed. Of course, this isn't necessarily a skill build, but it should be pretty obvious what primary skill at least we're selecting. The primary skill of choice is the Ballistic Shield. Obviously, there's no mod we can select because of the 4-piece bonus on the defense gear set. However, the Master Mod still applies. That means that the shield will repair itself after a short time without taking damage. The secondary skill is more debatable. Playing solo, we'll select the first aid with overheal. Playing with a dedicated healer, selecting the booster shot instead of the overheal can give you that little bit of extra damage to take down your target. Alternatively, running the pulse with tactical scanner can increase weapon damage as well as the critical hit damage and critical hit chance for a more DPS oriented build. The third skill, the signature skill, is meant to increase survivability, not only for us, but for our entire team. We're selecting the Survivor Link. It can be used to engage, or it can be used defensively against named enemies or tactical links from other players. It increases damage resistance by 50%, and if we need to catch the bus, it also applies a 30% bonus to movement speed, which is nice. Talents increase this build's effectiveness in a smaller but nonetheless important way. Their selection revolves around survivability, and we're selecting Adrenaline, Critical Save, Death by Proxy and On the Move. Adrenaline provides 7 seconds of immunity when using a medkit. We all know critical save. It decreases incoming damage by 20% for 10 seconds upon using a medkit at low health. This one is important if you want to be a bit more self-sustaining. Death by proxy increases skill power by 20% for 30 seconds when deploying a skill. Makes sense, we're constantly deploying skills and we'll have that extra bit of skill power, meaning extra health for our ballistic shield. And the last talent on the move reduces incoming damage by 15% for 10 seconds when killing a hostile while moving. And since we're not really using cover, as the shield is our cover, we're constantly on the move. And there you have it, a juggernaut, an absolute tank. Defense is strong in the current meta as well, so it's a good pick right now. I appreciate you taking the time out of your day to watch this content. If you made it this far, consider leaving a rating. Good or bad, doesn't matter. It provides us feedback and helps us showing up in the YouTube algorithm. Comment down below with your suggestions and how to build a classified defense. How would you build it? Before ending the video, here's a quick reminder. For those interested in being able to have a look at the build without rewatching it all over again, I designed blueprints for the gear, weapon, skills and talents. They're all available on Patreon, among other rewards for those who are willing to support us monetarily. The specifics can be found on Patreon. And that is what brings us to the end of the video. There are many ways to make a defensive build like this, from DPS to crowd control to bullet sponge, and that's what makes this build so viable in the current meta. That'll do it. Have a good day. Peace out.